Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be delving into something that is super useful for all civil engineers and land surveyors as a whole out there, which is extracting elevation data from surfaces in civil 3D. This skill is particularly essential for ensuring accuracy in our topographic projects. Whether you're working on railways, on land development, and any other civil tasks that have been assigned to, you do know that it's an easy way to extract elevation from civil 3D. Yeah, that's right. It's simpler than you might think. And today I'm going to show you how to go about that. Now, many a times we realize when we undertake a topographic work and then we come back to the office and we need to extract information, a particular elevation data from our work that we did on site, sometimes it becomes daunting. Hence the need for this video. So let's dive right into it. So to begin, we launch our Civil 3D software. When that is done, we inspect our data. In that case, we've undertaken a topographic survey of the area. I want to be able to extract elevations of some point to be used for further processing. This is our elevation data we gathered on site. This house are Eastern, Northern, Z's. And we go on ahead to inspect our data that we want to extract from the survey we undertook. In that case, it doesn't have any elevation here. So upon completion of this video, we will be able to extract the elevation for further use. Now let's jump right into it. Launch our Civil 3D software. We start by creating a surface from which you are going to extract the elevation data. Mind you, there's a previous video that shows you how to create a surface using Civil 3D. So I'll just walk you right through it. So we start by creating our surfaces. We click on surface, then we create our surface. We name our surface. We assign a style, in that case is the contour 1x5, and then we select a layer to which we work on. We OK to create our surface. We click on the drop down and we realize our surface has been created. Go to our definitions and then we now generate our surface from the point that was shown earlier. So we come down to point file, so right click, we add, click on the plus sign, and we navigate to our file. So we select our file and then we open. After opening our file, we realize they are not filtered to our specification, so we go through our filter points and then we select how we want our data, or which format we want our data to look. In that case, the points, the elevations, the nothing, the instance, and the descriptions. Once you're satisfied that they match with our headers, we click on OK. Now, to be able to preview our surface, we zoom and then we go to extent. Our surface has been successfully created. So we are going on to the purpose of the video. Now we display our point onto our area of interest by going to our point feature, point creation, and then we import our point. We navigate to where the points are without whose elevations are unknown that we want to be able to extract. So we click on the points and then we open them. We select our appropriate header and then realize from here that our elevations are unknown. Now when the data is formatted, we create a separate layer for the files we are about to import and then we name them. When we are done naming them, we okay them. We realize our points have been displayed on our surface. When we go on properties, under the information tab, and then we edit the properties to be displayed properly. Once our point feature properties have been properly displayed, we right click on the point feature and then we go to edit points. Now the elevations here have been displayed or they have no elevation value. To need to update them, we select on one file and then we highlight all the files for most elevation we want to update. We right click, then we go to elevations from surface. We select our appropriate surface, and then we OK. Once the command run, we realize the elevations have been successfully updated. Now to be able to use, we export into an Excel to be used in any third-party software. So we navigate to our file and then we name our new file that has elevations. We open and then we OK. Now the elevations have been successfully updated. Now to check that, we go to our folder, open our previous file. It had zero elevations, and then our new file whose elevations have been updated. You can see from here that both elevations have now been updated. Alright folks, all too soon we've come to the end of yet another video. If you enjoyed this video or have any questions about the process, drop a comment below. I'd love to hear about your experiences or any challenges you faced. And while you're at it, don't forget to check out our other videos in advanced civil 3D techniques. Until next time, keep designing and happy drafting. It's bye-bye for now.